purpose of this video is to explore the use of the UNIFAC function in the activity coefficient spreadsheet, which I'm showing here, in order to calculate liquid-liquid phase equilibrium. And in order to do this, I'm going to use the UNIFAC LLEA and LLEB spreadsheets. And this is actually described, I encourage you to look at section 12.6 in the textbook, which is an optional section that we didn't assign, but which describes how you would want to set up this spreadsheet in order to do liquid-liquid phase equilibrium calculations. So I've gone ahead and set up a problem with two components, and we want to look at whether these components form different liquid phases. The components that I've set up are methanol and hexane, and I've gone ahead and looked up the Antoine coefficients for those and put them in here. And you can see that the saturation pressures at 25 degrees C are correspondingly calculated, although we won't directly make use of those in this calculation. We then can specify liquid phase compositions for component alpha in LLEA and component beta. Okay, and you see that I've initially guessed compositions of 10%, 90%, and 90%, 10% of the two liquid phases. And the spreadsheet calculates the activity coefficients for you. All right, what we'll use is in the alpha phase spreadsheet, we'll use this Ki formulation, right, where we need to make an initial guess of Ki. And to do that, we just divide the activity coefficient for component 1 in the alpha phase by the activity coefficient for component 1 in the beta phase on the other spreadsheet. And so I've just put that into this cell. And then we do the same thing for component 2. So gamma 2 sub alpha divided by gamma 2 sub beta. For our x old values that we're going to use in our iteration, as is described in section 12.6, we're just going to set those equal to what we put in for our alpha and beta phases inside the spreadsheet. And so I just have a straight equality here, or should. All right, so this should be equal to C22, and so I need to maybe make this exactly 0.1. Okay, and we do the same thing for X in the beta phase. So I just have an equality to the spreadsheet over that describes the beta phase. And then we just basically go through an iterative procedure that's described in the textbook in order to achieve convergence in the values of X1 alpha and X2 alpha and X1 beta and X2 beta. And so I've defined these cells exactly as described in step 3 of section 12.6. Right, and so I'll let you read about the equations there, but they're very clearly described in terms of the spreadsheet. And you can pause and look at the cells as I've defined them here if you want. And so we just use 1 minus x1 alpha to get x2 alpha. And then for our x1 beta nu, we actually multiply our k values times our x1 alpha values for both cells, right, as is described in the textbook. Right, and now we basically will do an iterative procedure where we'll take our x1 and x2 alpha for our alpha phase, and we will paste them in here. And we have to be sure to paste values. Right, we do the same thing with the new values for the beta phase, and that requires that we go over to this other sheet. And again, be sure to paste the values. And then we return here. And the last thing we need to do to complete our iteration is then copy the Ki nu and paste that special, paste values, into the Ki old. Okay, and now we can see that we have new values for x compared to our previous values. So our xi old was from the first iteration was 0.88. We initially started with 0.9 and then went to 0.88. Our new iteration has xi as 0.87. And we have new values for the beta x's as well. All right, we can keep on doing these iterations. So we can take our new guesses, again, just as we did previously, and plug them in for our new values of x, and we eventually will converge, and I think I've done this, and end up getting about 84% for the xi alpha value and maybe around 18% for the xi beta value by the time you go through all the calculations. But we just keep repeating that cutting and pasting, always making sure to paste values where we paste in the xi alpha, the xi beta, and the ki new into the ki old, just as we've done in the first step in order to converge on the solution.